I'ma keep it a bean. Stick to script every scene. This from last year, but they clean. Say to say, I'ma take something else, but it's winning team. Charlie Sheen, fam gang, the regime. I'm from Piney Green.
It's been overdue forever. Ask me when it was dropping, said never. Never. Should've made you cut the feta. But I designed it Freemason Margiela.
What's good, Shellitronnn? Trying to hear the most woke, no joke, and I'm back at it again with a brand new video. And Marty Hurney, GM of the Carolina Panthers, is back at it again, being an extremely, extremely impressive GM. His second stint in Charlotte and the Carolina Panthers has been very, very impressive. There's no other way of explaining it, no other way of describing it. But just yesterday, he went on a sports talk show on WFNZ. He said, a bad O-line can keep you up at night. Moton is preferred at right tackle. Where Williams fits, we will see. And then names all depth options on the line. This is a tweet here from Travis Hancock, who is a co-host of a show called The Mac Attack. I've never listened to this show. I don't listen to a lot of radio at all. I don't listen to sports radio at all. But this is a very, very illuminating, tweet here. But if you'll allow me to just take a really quick trip down memory lane, not too far, but I mean, I'm no Tony Stark, but let's take a real quick. You ready? There's five spots on the line, and there's two spots already taken. We already know that Matt Parrish is going to be our center. We know that Trey Turner's going to be our right guard. But then there's the other question about where are these guys going to play. I've been seeing a lot of people assuming that, you know, Taylor Moton's going to be playing left guard. Says who? Why do people assume that Daryl Williams is going to be playing right tackle? I think the two are about at the same level of a talent at right tackle. And in a lot of ways, I feel like playing left guard will be easier on Daryl Williams' knees, on his legs, so he can still have really good production and not risk getting hurt. I would not feel all that bad about Daryl Williams playing left guard. We back? Are we good? Everyone safe? Everyone good? All right. I have one more thing to show you. This one goes back not a week, but actually a full month in the past. Hope you're all ready. Do not throw open my time machine. Calibrate this right here, and realistically, my plan of action would probably be to give Taylor Moton the right tackle position, and then let Jonah and Daryl fight for a left tackle and left guard, and see whoever plays better gets left tackle, whoever plays worse gets left guard. We good? Everyone safe? Everyone make it back? As you just heard, I've been asking the question for a minute now. The overwhelming majority of people have been telling me that Daryl Williams is a for sure lock to be the right tackle for the Panthers this upcoming season. Obviously because that's his more natural position. He's coming off of an injury. He's on a prove it deal. And actually, that's another point I want to make right now. I think I mentioned this in the video, I think yesterday or whenever it was. I'm not really sure. But there are some guys on the team right now that we know who are on 1 year deals, who are just on 1 year deals. They're just like, you know, stopgap kind of guys. But I mentioned there are some guys on the team who are on one-year deals who a lot of fans believe are on prove-it deals, but I'm not all that convinced that some of these guys who we think are on prove-it deals are actually on prove-it deals, and I think Daryl Williams is one of those guys, a guy who we all assume is on a deal where, you know, if he plays well this year, he's not getting a lot of money, but assuming he plays well, the team will, you know, give him a lot more money, give him a long-term extension for next season. Who's to actually say that the team, that's what the team's plan is here? I am not all that sure that no matter how well or poorly that Daryl Williams plays this season, I think he's just, you know, it kind of sucks to say, but I think he's really good, cheap talent that we were able to capitalize on because not a lot of other teams in the league were trying to give him a big bag and he'd rather just stay here and prove himself than, you know, uproot his whole family and, you know, try to prove himself somewhere else. But the main point of this video is to point out that look, Taylor Moton is most likely going to be our right tackle, and Greg Little and Daryl Williams are going to be pretty much fighting and competing for that left tackle spot. I'm pretty much guessing that they're not going to be competing for the left guard spot. I'm sure it's going to be whoever plays the best in mini camp, you know, in training camp, preseason. That's going to be the real position battle we look at in this offseason to see who's playing left tackle, who's playing left guard. And I think that's about what Coach Rivera was alluding to when he said that, you know, Greg Little is not going to be given that left tackle job. He has to earn it. And I was thinking to myself, that's kind of a weird thing to say. But given the scope of this and in this context, it makes perfect sense. Greg Little could be a really good left tackle. He has amazing pass blocking abilities. But like I mentioned in my video doing my breakdown of him, he had really bad at the combine. He was really bad at the bench press. No matter how you talk about it, like long arms, whatever. 15 reps on the bench press is not good. It's good for pass blocking, or it's not bad for pass blocking, but for run blocking, it is pretty bad. And, I mean, maybe we can see him, you know, being moved to left guard. But also, if you think about it, Daryl Williams being moved to left guard, it will be a much less stressful position for his knees. We can make sure that he's actually healthy. And honestly, I mean, with Greg Little, if we have runs to the left side, we can put a tight end over there. We can have a lead blocker on that side. We don't have to, you know, have him out on an island by himself if it's going to be a run to the left. Or we can, you know, throw some misdirection there, get guys off their block, off their spot. So we can do different things to scheme around Greg Little. And if he does get better at run blocking, then that's great. But not to hone in on small details for too long in this video. This is just to, you know, talk about how Marty Hurney, the coaching staff, and the whole team is extremely flexible. These guys can think deeply. They can say to themselves, okay, look, man, we know that Taylor Moton played very well. And personally, I actually love this announcement right here from Marty Hurney because, you know, as much as I love competitiveness and competition and seeing, you know, guys work and fight for a starting role on a team, I wasn't all that good with knowing that we'd be going to training camp and, you know, preseason with only 2 spots of the 5 spots on the O-line actually set in stone and ready to go, only Trey Turner and Matt Paradis. It feels a lot better to know that we have 3 spots locked in, and it's not like a 3-way competition to see, okay, who's right tackle? Okay, now, who's left tackle? Okay, who's left guard here? You have a 3-way kind of like, that would be kind of confusing, kind of weird, and no one will get the kind of reps they actually deserve at different spots. You'd have guys, you know, coming in at right tackle, then, okay, let's see how you do at left guard. Okay, see how you do at left tackle. And this is way too much reps, way too many different things, too many techniques to work out there. And, you know, having our right tackle set in stone right now, and it's having 2 guys battle for 2 spots rather than 3 guys battle for 3 spots, I think works a lot better for us. And it'll give the coach the chance to see a lot deeper into what these guys' actual skill set is. And I think we all assume that Daryl Williams could possibly transition to a left tackle pretty seamlessly, or at least seamlessly enough to still be productive as a tackle. I think as a team, as a front office, as a coaching staff, you have to think to yourself, are the benefits of having Daryl Williams be a left tackle and potentially getting hurt as a tackle, do those outweigh, you know, his abilities as a left guard and making sure he can stay healthy? And, you know, putting Greg Little through the ringer as a rookie during training camp and during preseason and all that kind of stuff, and making sure he's ready to go, because he's probably going to be the future of our left tackle spot. You know, getting him ready and getting him prepared as a left tackle for that whole period of time would probably be better than, you know, having him spend his whole rookie year as a left guard and then moving him over the next season. It's possible, but I actually really do want to see how we do here. And it's like a thing you have to actually think about as a coach. Like, you know, there's things you have to weigh out here. And sometimes the quick and easy solution may not actually be the best solution in the long term. That's how I feel about it. I don't have really much more to go into on this one. This is something that we're definitely going to be talking about later on, definitely during training camp, definitely during the preseason. This is going to be one of the most important position battles that we have on the team. Now, we do obviously want to know who's going to be the nickel corner, who's going to be playing free safety, and we'll get into all that later. And if I'm going to go ahead and, you know, make a prediction right here, I think it's going to be Greg Little at left tackle, and we're going to have Daryl Williams at left guard. I think we're just going to try to maintain his health this season. Hopefully he plays really good at left guard, and we get some really good reps out of him. And honestly, I really don't see the team re-signing him next year. I could be wrong. I've been wrong before, but for the money he's looking for, I just don't see it happening. We could probably just draft another guy. And don't forget about Tyler Larson. Tyler Larson is a starter caliber player on the team. I think he could be a good left guard as well. I'll leave it at that, though. What are your thoughts on this? Do you like the idea of Taylor Moton playing right tackle? Would you rather see Daryl Williams? Do you think Greg Little will be ready to be the blind side protection for Cam in his rookie season, going up against some pretty good edge rushers in this NFC South division and the NFL in general? What are your thoughts on Daryl playing left tackle or left guard? What are your thoughts on, you know, maybe him re-injuring himself? I feel like maybe we are focusing a little bit too much, at least I am, maybe focusing a little bit too much on the risk of Daryl Williams re-injuring himself, like as if he's injury prone or something like that. I don't think he's injury prone, but I think as far as the O-line goes, I would rather take the least amount of risk, especially when you consider just how injury prone the line's been in general, not really specifically with Daryl Williams. But look, I don't want to see Cam get hurt, and although I would love to see Will Greer play some really good quality snaps, the only way he's going to do that is if Cam can't go, and I'd rather see Cam go than see Will Greer play. That's just how the game works. Anyway, man, let me know all your thoughts in the comments below. And one last thing before I go, if you want to show support for the channel, go down to that pinned comment below, sign the petition, man. I think we're getting pretty close to 600 signatures on the petition to get the Panthers to partner with this channel, man. We do a lot of pretty good content here, and we can make some even bigger and better content. I need your support. You guys have been really great about it so far, man. And as always, you already know to do that like button.
Cheers to you, appreciate the chance. Being told y'all I've been the man. Being told y'all I had the gift. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Real ones gonna recommend. Count this as another win.